In this particular video, I'm going to show you how to create those 3D skin tones. You know those skin tones that bring more depth into an image? Yes, those are the kind of skin tones I'm going to show you. Yo, what's up my brother? What's up my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. When you do frequency separation on an image, most of the times an image tends to be flat. Now, what we want to do is create more dimension, more depth in this particular image so that it looks even more deep, more present, so that it pops off the background. So how are we going to do this? Definitely, we're going to go in step by step, and let me show you. We're going to use curves adjustment layers. Ready? Let's dive into this. Okay, so what we're going to do here, we're going to come here and get our curves adjustment layer, and what we're going to do, we're just going to push down the skin tones just like that. Only look at the skin tones. Don't look at the hair. Look at her skin tones. Only that. Yeah. Then we are also going to come here with another curves adjustment layer. And we're going to just make these come off just like that. Okay. Then we're going to come and remove this. So the next thing we're going to do, we're now just going to come and create what they call blend if. To use blend if. Now, this one is going to be for the mid-tones. Yeah. When I talk about mid-tones, I mean the browns, those the brown skin tones, the chocolate color, that bronze color that comes with the dark skin tones. Yeah, if you're editing a Caucasian, definitely you'll still have to bring down those pinks and those particular tones a bit down, then so that you have that color more emphasized, that color more intense. The goal is to add more intensity in the mid-tones. So the next thing we're going to do here, we're going to come here and then double click onto this layer. Before we double click, let's rename this highlights. Okay, because what creates depth in an image basically it is the difference between the highlights and the shadows or the mid-tones. So we are going to create that contrast in between the two shades within an image. Okay, so we're going to come here into mid-tones, just double click onto the layer, and then we come into this blend if. And then we're just going to move this forward and get it away from the hair, just like that. You know, I don't want to get it away so far away. I just want to keep it there. So when you look at the edges, they're a bit graphical. So how do we just have them be gradual? So you press Alt or Option on your keyboard, and then you click this and you divide the blend if, and then you divide it up like that, you know, just like that. So we're going to adjust it until we see that this thing is, you know, accurate enough to our test. Okay? Because if you leave it so graphical, we don't want it so graphical. We want it to blend in just like you see that. So the next thing we're going to do now, we're now going to work on the highlights. Okay? So you come into the highlights here, and then still you double click the layer, and then you still click this particular piece. And then you drive it forward and you drive it away from the shadow area, and you make sure it's only the highlights that are showing. So you see, it's only the highlights, you know, the cheek, the forehead, the nose, the cheekbone, that forehead, all these. We want them to be to pop. So what are we going to do? We are just going to come here and then press Alt or Option on your keyboard, and then just drive it forward, like, just like that. We just want to blend it so that it doesn't get that graphical. See that graphical feel? That's not what we'd want. So we want to press Alt on our keyboard. We divide it and then we make it more gradual. More gradual, just like that. So the next thing you're going to do, I'm going to put this in a group. Yes, like that. Now let me, and then look at the before. That's the before, that's the after. Before and after. So however, we don't want this in our background, and we don't want it in places where we really don't want it to affect. I don't want it to affect the background. So what do I do? I just come and select this. I will rename this group skin tones. Yes. And then I'll just come click onto it and then create an adjustment layer just right next to it. So I'm going to press Ctrl I or Command I if you're using a Mac to invert this particular layer so that I get the effect off. And then that's just that. So I'm just going to come with a brush here, you know, and then leave the opacity and flow at 100, and then remove the hardness from the brush and just paint white over here to reveal. Remember, black hides and white reveals. So I want to reveal the effect on just particular parts that whose skin tones I want to be as awesome as can be. By the way, if you want to see how I retouch this whole image and how I do high-end retouching for my portrait photography, click the first link in the description below and join the Retouching Secrets Masterclass. It is a masterclass that takes you step by step on how to edit high-end images. By next Friday, trust me, you will have your images popping. And this masterclass, so far I have thousands of students that have enrolled into this and they are enjoying the whole masterclass. Make sure you join right now because I have a one-time offer running, but I don't know when I'm going to increase the price, but anytime from now I'll be increasing the prices. But as of now, I have a special one-time offer running. That aside, you come here and get your white paint, and then we paint back these particular skin tones, because I just want it to affect only and only the skin tone area. You know, it doesn't have to be really accurate painting and the like, but we just want to have those, that glowing skin. When somebody looks at the skin, they feel like, you know, it has that bit of a glow. Now just imagine this printed as a magazine cover or something. Look at this. That's the before, that's the after. Now I don't want the effect also in the eyes, so I'll just come and reduce the brush size. Then remember I told you black hides, and then I will just come here and say, and just paint it away from the eyes. And there you have it. That's how you create those awesome glowing tones in your images. I hope to see you in the next one. If you've not yet subscribed to this channel, of course, subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you in the next one.